Are loops pointless? Well, seriously, a lot of people have problems understanding loops. If you can understand the if statement, then you can understand the loop. Here's a simple example. Keep watching. To use in, we're going to create a string called phrase, where we've got two words, one of two letters, one of four letters, that's a cartoon character. And then we're going to use the if statement to see if a letter is in this phrase. Let's have a look at the letters. Letter A. Yes, A is in there. Letter E. E is there as well. S is not there. T is not there. N is there. Letter R is there. Oh, I think I know what it is. Do you? Let's have a guess. I think it's Mr. Bean. Yes, correct. Here we've got a list of three numbers, 2, 4, and 6. If the number's 2, it's going to print 2. If the number's 1, it's not there, so there's no output. So what are we doing with the if statement? We're going through each letter to see if it's there. So we're looking for S. It's going through every letter and it's not there. Now look at the for loop. So we're going to go through each letter, including the space, until we get to the end. So it's very similar to the if statement, but the if statement is looking to see if it's true or false. It's just true or just false. The for loop looks through each character in the string phrase. So in our example, it would print M R space B E A N. And another example with the numbers, so we had 2, 4 and 6, it's going to output 2, then 4, then 6. It prints them all on a different line. So here's a question, why is it called a loop? Well, here's our if statement. We've got numbers 2, 4 and 6, and if the number's there, it's going to do these print statements. There's 3. So let's look at number 2. It's going to go down and print 2, 2, 2. What about a for loop? We've got the same numbers. We've got the same 3 print statements. So here, we're going to print 2, 2, 2. But it's going to loop round and then print 4, 4, 4. And then loop round and print 666. That's why it's called a loop. Let's go through some code. Here we have the simple for loop. I'm going to print each letter and the output is HELLO. Here the string is 6 stars, so the output will be 6 stars. Here we have a date. Each character is printed, including the space, AUG space 21. How about numbers? Here's a list of numbers, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. As you can imagine, the output will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. How about floats? 1.5, 2.5, 3.5. Here's a list of numbers. Some are integers, some are floats. The output, 2, 2.5, 3, 4, 5. If you understand these, you can try to test your knowledge with some practice. Okay, so write this code. Print every letter in your name, your whole name. Number 2, print numbers 1 to 10. Number 3, print every letter in the alphabet. Okay, good luck with them. Stop the video, have a go, and then once you're confident you can do them, come back to check the answers. Okay, first one, print every letter in your name. So the string name will be your name, and then in the for loop we go through each letter. You can see that it prints the space between the words. Next one was numbers 1 to 10, quite straightforward. We can print them, so it's printing 1 to 10. And the alphabet, we can, if we like, list every single letter and then print them. There are other ways to code different tasks, and we'll go into the different ways in future videos. Okay, just to clear up some terms, a loop just repeats the following instructions. A for loop is a loop uses a for keyword. A list, we had like a list of numbers, so it's a collection of items, could be numbers, floats, strings, even other lists. And iterate, when you go through a loop, each time you go through it is called iteration. So you iterate through a loop. Okay, great, hope you enjoyed that video, and thank you for watching. If you haven't before, please subscribe and click on like and click the bell. Even comment. Bye for now.